Thanks so much, Claudia, and we're thrilled to be here. I'm Nick Halsey. I'm the president and CEO of Zoomdata. Justin and our team started Zoomdata because of the absolute revolution in what's happening with modern data, with modern IT fabrics, with elastic cloud, and all of these. Usually it's one driver that triggers a wave of BI innovation, but this is like tectonic plates shifting. So Zoomdata today is a five-year-old company. We were started from scratch by Justin in 2012 to address this critical need for big and fast data analytics in this emerging modern BI world. The product has really been commercially available at production grade for about 2 years and a bit. And we've met with pretty phenomenal acceptance in rather a short period of time. The growth is phenomenal. This year has been about us expanding internationally. We're about an 80-person company now, headquartered in Reston, Virginia, and San Mateo, California. We have about 50 customers. That's growing quickly. We really see kind of a 50-50 split. Large enterprises who are struggling with big data and know they need to be able to do analytics on big and fast data to really have a competitive advantage in today's market. And then this incredible emerging market where both software companies, but even enterprises, are embedding analytics into applications and business processes to really bring analytics to the point of execution where it can have a meaningful impact on everyday business.
So today's challenges, of course, are the streaming aspect that is talked about. People have the data coming in continuously. It's no batches anymore. So there's a lot of good reasons to just go to completely end-to-end streaming for data warehousing. Ideally, all ETL and data transport should be on a stream. And so what we've really taken the strategy of at Zoomdata is really building native connectivity, not just using JDBC or ODBC, none of this kind of masking layer that all the other BI vendors have really had to use trying to address some of these new data stores. We've built really native connectivity that can really leverage the power of each of these data stores independently. And that really appeals to the customers who have, you know, bet big on any one of these, and also customers who have bet big on a combination or a portfolio of these things. And if you don't have a native ability to address those functions, you can't expose that to the end user. And so we're focused a lot on providing a really modern embedded toolkit so that people can embed analytics directly where the users are, as opposed to having them have to go to a standalone tool. So Zoomdata uses a technique called microquery data sharpening. It's a patented approach we came up with very early on at Zoomdata that instead of running a single query against data, it runs a stream of little tiny queries against data and shows the results as they come back. So Zoomdata is deployable, therefore, in multiple manners. We have the ability to do Java kind of standard Linux installations. We have the ability to Docker-based deployments. You can run Zoomdata inside a Docker container. We have the ability to do Mesos-based deployments. So if you have a Mesos framework. So we're using a lot of modern deployment stuff that allows Zoomdata to deploy both on-premises, even on our customers' premises, in a very seamless manner. And also, of course, we have the ability to run all that in cloud too. So Zoomdata is purely a BI front end, a BI layer. We do have a server thing that does the back end processing, but we do not do any data wrangling. We do not do any ETL. We do not do any data cataloging. So things like Waterline, Tamer, Trifacta, Poxata, Informatica, these are all wonderful partners of ours because we don't step on their functionality at all. So a lot of other technologies will suck data out of backend data stores into memory cubes or into their own copies of data. And what's interesting about Zoomdata is that we never really do that. We always are pushing down the analysis into the underlying data stores. And that lets us do much deeper analysis and also drill down to raw data without having to make any copies of it.
Part of our architecture that's really different is the way we handle connectors. Each connector can be tailored to the unique properties of the source. Our connector infrastructure supports even the ability to do multi-cloud or hybrid cloud, where you can forward deploy connectors on-prem. So there's a range of different options that we support with all of this. We treat Spark as a distributed runtime that gives us good horizontal scalability, and we use memory structures that are provided by Spark that gives us, you know, that horizontal memory footprint. We excel where the other tools fail. We excel on flexibility, the ability to either embed in different ways, support different types of sources, run it on cloud, run it as part of your SaaS, no modeling required. even something as complex as a stream and looking at data in motion, simplified to a DVR metaphor, we really want to make it easy for people to explore, understand, share data-driven insights about the business in a world where everything's constantly changing.